Good morning, children. Welcome back to my class. Okay, today we are going to discuss about a new topic. But yesterday, what you learned? What is the lesson name? Food we need. And in yesterday's class, we learned about the ingredients of any food items. And what is the definition of ingredients? What are the materials required to prepare a particular food item are called ingredients. And coming to that, we are using different types of ingredients to prepare a particular food item. So, and also we are eating many different kinds of food. And here, I want to ask one question. See, these all items we are preparing in the same manner or not? No, it is not possible because we are using different methods while preparing of food. Today, we are going to learn about different methods of preparing food. What are the methods we are using? See, different methods of preparing food. So let us, we have to say the first one, boiling. The first method is boiling. Do you know how to boil this any food items? Only some particular food items only we can use this method of boiling. What are the examples? For example, every day we are eating rice. The rice is using with the process of boiling only. And coming to the potatoes and eggs also. See, for example, if you want to boil the eggs, what you have to do? We have to keep in that water, and if you keep on the flame, automatically after some time it will be boil only. Some of the food items like rice and boiled potatoes and eggs we can prepare in this way only. That is the method of boiling. Example, rice and also boiled eggs and also potatoes. Okay, and coming to that, second one method is steaming. Second method is steaming. And do you know what is meant by steaming? Steam. The another name of the steam is water vapor. See how when that water vapor will come? When we heat the water, automatically after some time we will get water vapor. So with that water vapor we can prepare some food items. That process only we call as steaming. And which food items we can prepare with this steaming? Example, see, if you see, how can we prepare, or how can your mother prepare idli? See, if you see the idli box, they will pour some water, and when they will keep upon the flame after some time, with that steaming only, that idlis can we can prepare. So that process we can call as steaming. And also third one is fermentation. What is meant by fermentation? Here, this one process. Okay, fermentation is a process. What is the process? Do you know how to prepare curd? See, and what are the materials required to prepare curd? Boiled milk, only boiled milk. See, for example, how can we prepare the curd? See, in how can we prepare curd? If you want to prepare curd, we can add little bit of yesterday's buttermilk only. And after that time, after some a long time, this milk can turn into a hard structure called curd. And what is present in that previous buttermilk? Lactobacillus. Lactobacillus, one bacterium is present in that. This bacterium can help turn into that milk into curd. not only this bacterium, not only this curd, and coming to that, while we are preparing bread and also like doshas, see, if your mother wants to prepare any dosha, she will prepare before day only, because after fermentation only it will give some new taste. So that is the process of fermentation. Okay, and what are the materials and what are the food items we can prepare with this fermentation? Example, dosha mix and also bread. While we are preparing bread and also some idli mix, these all also jalebi mix also example for the fermentation. And coming to the fourth one is roasting. Roasting means it is also comes under the deep fry. See, when we have to prepare any pakoda or something or pallis, these all also we can prepare in that deep fry or roasting only. And also some of the food items like chicken also we can prepare with this roasting only. Example, chicken or any pakodi. These all also, vada, dosha, these all also comes under that roasting only. And fifth one is cutting and mixing. Cutting and mixing. See, for example, all vegetables we have to cut, and after that only we can mix with that any different materials. So all vegetable curries comes under this method only, cutting and mixing. And two more are there, chopping and mixing. Chopping and mixing. And this is also one method. And what are the food items we can prepare with this chopping and mixing? Example, salads. Nowadays we all are showing interest to eat the salads only. To prepare this salad we can use the chopping and mixing. And seventh one is shallow frying means you can fry a little bit enough for this shallow frying. Example, fish. These are the different methods of preparing food. Here see, we are eating different kinds of food, but all food items we are not preparing in the same manner. So we are using different methods. What are the different methods? Boiling, steaming, fermentation, roasting, cutting and mixing, chopping and mixing, and shallow frying. These all methods also we are using to prepare the food item. And while we are eating food, we generally can say this food item is very tasty. And how the taste will come? Anybody will add any taste flavor in that? Nothing. So the taste of food depends on the ingredients. See, tasty food. How the taste will come, children? See, the tasty food, it is depending upon the ingredients. Ingredients. And the tasty food depends on ingredients and method of preparation. Method of preparation. Preparation. Okay, see how the taste will come. The tasty food is depend upon the ingredients and method of preparation. For example, see, if you are using the unquality ingredients, automatically the taste will lose. And if you keep so much of ingredients, then if you don't know how to prepare that food item, automatically the food item will be get spoiled. So the tasty of food is depend upon the ingredients and method of preparation. Now let us prepare a tasty food item upma. Upma. See, first of all, we have to write aim. What is the aim of this? Prepare upma. Prepare upma. And second, what you have to write? Materials required. Materials are needed. Materials needed. What are the materials needed, children? You know, say what are the names? First of all, Bombay Suji. Bombay Suji. And after that, what you have to need? Green chilli. And curry leaves and cashew, and after that red chilli, oil, salt, and after that jeera, and after what we have to need? Some other items we need to prepare a upma. And coming to the process, what we have to do the process? Say after that what you have to do? First of all, keep a bowl upon the flame, and after that pour some oil in that kettle or a pan. First of all, keep some oil in that pan. After some time, when the oil is boiling, after that you can add the onion pieces, green chilies, red chilies, and some spices like jeera and urad dal and green chili, red chili, curry leaves, and after that time you have to pour 2 cups of water, and when this water is boiling, after that you have to add the Bombay Suji to that water. Stir it well. After some time, a very tasty upma ready. So this is the result. This is the result. So like this only you have to write the preparation of your favorite food item. Okay, favorite food item. First of all, you have to write aim, materials needed, and write the process of the particular food item, and at last you have to write that result. And some of the people making designs with vegetables. So that making designs we called as vegetable carving. Making designs with vegetables is called vegetable carving. And you have to try two vegetable carving. Mostly we discussed about the food items, but the discussion will not complete without talking about the preservation of food. The discussion will be incomplete because we have to discuss with the preservation of food. What is the meaning of preservation? Preservation means storing the food item. What is the meaning of preservation? Preservation means storing the food item. Preservation is the process treating and handling the food, slow down the spoilage of food. See, preservation is the process. Preservation is the process. If the food is not preserved properly, automatically after some time the food will get germs, and after some time it will be spoiled. If you eat the spoiled food, you may get vomitings and also abdominal pain and also some diarrhea, and sometimes it may be lead to death also. So don't eat that type of spoilage food. So first of all, we have to know about the how to preserve the food items. See here, preservation means keeping for a long time. For example, if your mother, if they are remind any yesterdays, any milk or any food items, they will keep in their refrigerators. But at the same time, some pickles also is there. These pickles, if they will not prepare, they will not preserve in that refrigerator, because it is not possible to preserve in that refrigerator. So for that, they are using some preservatives. So the materials which are used in that preservation are called preservatives. Okay, preservatives. So, what are the preservatives? In that, two types are there. Natural preservatives and chemical preservatives. Natural preservatives and chemical preservatives. What is the meaning of preservatives? The materials which are using in preservation are called preservatives. And in these two types are there. One is natural preservatives and second one is chemical preservatives. What are the natural preservatives? First of all, salt, oil, tamarind and turmeric. Turmeric powder. These also we called as natural preservatives. And coming to the second, chemical preservatives. And coming to the chemical preservatives, benzoates, nitrates and sulfates. These are the chemical preservatives. But see children, these chemical preservatives are very dangerous to our health. See, so much of we have to use these natural preservatives only. What are the natural preservatives? Salt, oil, tamarind and turmeric. And what are the chemical preservatives? Benzoates, nitrates and sulfates. And these chemical preservatives are very harmful to our body. They can damage our digestive system. In our textbook, they given pressure for food and types of preservatives. Types of preservatives and examples. Examples. See, what are the first one? Using salt, chili powder and oil. Chili powder and oil. Come on, say what is the example of this? Already in summer season, your grandmothers will prepare that. Come on, say that. Pickles. P-I-C-K-L-E-S. Pickles. Pickles can preserve using with salt, chili powder and oil. And coming to that, adding only salt. Adding only salt. See, what are that? Example, say dry fish. Dry fish is the example for adding only salt. And some of the food materials, they are using sugar syrup. Sugar syrup. What is the example for this? Come on, say cherry. Cherries. In sweet shop, if you observe, you can see that sugar syrup, the cherries, they can keep in the sugar syrup only. And what are the fourth one? See, adding salt and turmeric. Salt and turmeric. What is that? Example, tamarind. If you want to keep a tamarind, you can fully keep in that salt and turmeric. And at last one, drying. And at last one, you can keep drying. So, example, tomatoes and mangoes. Tomatoes, mangoes. These are the additional types of preservatives. Adding salt and turmeric, you can use the example of tamarind. And drying, the example of tomatoes or mangoes. We can keep them in the sunlight only. These are the preserved food, the types of preservatives. See what is meant by preservation? Storing the food for a long time. And what is the use of preservation? The preservation can damage the spoilage of food. And types of preservatives. There are two types, natural preservatives and chemical preservatives. What are the natural preservatives? oil, salt, turmeric, tamarind are the natural preservatives, and coming to the chemical preservatives are benzoates, nitrates and sulfates. And coming to these types of preservatives, adding salt, chili powder and oil, examples pickles, and adding only salt is dry fish, and sugar syrup is example of cherries. And coming to adding salt and turmeric is tamarind, and at last one is drying tomatoes and mangoes. See, one most important point children, here while you purchasing any food item, you have to see the manufacturing date and expiry date. And sometime if you eat that expiry date of food, it is damage our health. Please note this point. Next one, how do people develop their food habits? See, come on, mostly our people, mostly we are eating rice only, paddy, because according to our climatic and geographical condition, our weather is suitable for to producing the paddy only. Because rice is the main food for us, and we are using a different kind of materials with that rice only. And if you compare with other states, they can eat different food items. Like if you see Rajasthan, most of they will eat wheat or rice chapati only, because according to their climatic conditions, they will only producing that wheat only, so that almost all they will eat only chapati or roti or puri only. But according to our geographical or climatic conditions, we can produce only, our farmers can cultivate only paddy. And nowadays we are eating, see, we have to eat other cereals like finger millets, means the finger millets name is ragulu, and peral millets name is sajjalu, and great millets name is jonnalu, and foxtail millets is name is korralu, and proso millets somalu. So which are good for our health? Nowadays all people are using these items only, but many times we hear people saying that I don't want to eat this type of curry and I don't like this curry. But children, you don't say like that, because you have to eat the full food item. So without this food also so many people are there. So we have to eat the all food items what our parents are providing to us. That is a very good habit. Don't tell that I don't like this curry and that curry. And homemade food is very healthy and hygienic also. So always you have to prefer the food homemade only. In our country, so many poor people are there, so they don't have any food to eat. But some of the people, they are wasting food in hotels and also some special occasions. Please don't waste the food, and if you want to pour the food, please give the food to anybody. Because it is our duty as a responsible citizen. See children, what we learn in this lesson. First of all, components of food, and what are the ingredients. So what is the definition of ingredients? Materials are required to prepare a particular food items are called ingredients, and we get these ingredients from plants and also animals and also other sources. And these ingredients, we can eat some of the edible parts of plants, and some of the plants we can eat roots, stems, leaves, flowers and also fruits and seeds. And coming to that, we will get some food from animals also, like milk and also some meat, fishes, these all also. And animals we get obtained from that, plant is there, what is that? Salt we will get from only ocean or sea only. And also what we learned in this, the tasty food will depend upon the ingredients and also method of preparation. And what are the methods of preparation? Boiling, steaming, fermentation, roasting, shallow frying, cutting and mixing, chopping and mixing, and also one most is there. What is that? Say come on. And shallow frying. And also we learned how to prepare upma and what is the aim of upma and what are the materials are required to prepare upma and what is the preparation of preparing upma and also at last what we can. And again you have to write the procedure of your favorite food item. And also we discussed about preservation. What is meant by preservation? Storing the food items for a long time is called preservation. What is the main aim of preservation? To regulate the spoilage of food. And also they are using some natural preservatives in the preservation, and some of the chemical preservatives also present they are using nowadays. And coming to the different preservatives and types of preservatives, what are that? Adding only salt, adding oil, turmeric powder and also chili powder, and in some items adding only sugar syrup, and also drying. One more type is drying, and one more type is adding salt and turmeric. And how do people develop their food habits? According to their climatic and geographical conditions, people are cultivating their food. And most oftenly in our state, we can mostly using that to produce that rice only. But if you see that Rajasthan, they can mostly produce that wheat only. And don't waste that food also. Children, first of all, you have to read the full textbook, and after that, you have to underline the new words, and after that, tomorrow, I will explain with the question and answers. Thank you.